Joining us now is CBS News legal analyst Jack Ford. We've talked about this case a few times. Boy, this is an interesting latest twist. Where does it figure in? Because there are a few charges here that he's facing. Extortion is kind of at the back end.
Yeah, and you know, this sounds so disturbing, and I think your first instinct is, well, this must hurt him in terms of the Natalie Holloway case. Curiously, legally, it really doesn't. I mean, it's, you know, at best, it's stunningly insensitive by him. At worst, it could be a whole lot of other things. But legally, it's not an admission. He's not saying, yes, indeed, I killed her. He's saying, well, I wanted to get back at the parents here. So does it create another suspicious element in this whole big picture? Yes. But is it enough for a prosecutor to say, now we got him for Natalie Holloway? The answer is no.
I know, too, you know, this case in Peru, where he's being held now, charged with the murder of Stephanie Flores. Obviously, the laws are different in each country. The way trials are handled are different in each country. But when it comes to that trial in Peru, is this information that could be brought up, that could perhaps influence the case in any way, or not really? You
know, probably not. I mean, it might be out there on the periphery, and depending upon whether he testifies and says some things that might create an opening for this to come in, then you might hear something about it. But otherwise, I think the Peruvian case, they've got an awful lot of evidence against him, in addition to what they say is his confession. And as we heard from Jeff a few moments ago, that confession is still in play there and probably will be in play. So I don't think it would show up, and I don't think they really need it for that case.
Why is this guy still talking? I mean, you would think his attorney would say, just to be quiet, kid.
I used to say, I remember, and an older defense attorney said to me once when I first started practicing, you can protect against a lot of things except for the random acts of stupidity on the part of your own client. And one of the first things you say as a defense attorney to your client is, don't talk. I'll let you know if there's any conversation we're going to. I'll do the talking for you. Don't talk. But it seems that this guy has just this drive to talk about things that end up being very damaging for him. And it's puzzling as to why he'd be saying these things.
Do you think we could see in any of these cases some sort of a plea?
Well, you know what, if I'm his lawyer, again, I'm trying to package some of these things somehow. We heard him talking earlier on about how much he wants to get out of the Peruvian prison. And it looks like he's going to spend a chunk of time there.
And the conditions, as we've reported on, are
horrible. Yeah. So if I'm his lawyer, I might be saying, can we package something? Can we get the Peruvian authorities to say, look, if we admit to Natalie Holloway, can everybody agree that we will serve our time in Aruba as opposed to in this facility in Peru? So there's not a whole lot of him to do for negotiating because he's got some serious charges he's looking at. And he said back end of all of this is the extortion charges here in the United States. And basically, he just confessed to all of that.
Basically admitted to that. Jack, always great to have you here.
All right, Erica.
Thanks so much.